Imagine the value you have when you have been called as Amazon certified developer. That too doesn't require any prior knowledge. Hi, I am Kaustubh Sharma and I am a cloud engineer. Today, we are starting a brand new course of AWS, which stands for Amazon Web Services, specifically designed for 2020 syllabus. In this course, I tell you each and every step until you pass the exam. Just be with me. So let's get started. Here is some advice for this course. This course is a great advantage for freshers as well as for experienced professionals, as it doesn't require any prior knowledge of the cloud. The course is divided into small topics so you can understand the topic later also. Course is for those who really want to pass the AWS exam, who want to call as AWS certified developer. That's why I am talking point to point according to this exam. So before starting the course, fix your exam date just like 3 months from the starting of the course. But the date should be fixed. Don't hesitate to rewatch the lectures if you don't understand them or any important topics videos just before going for an exam or an interview. You should do hands-on along with the course. First, watch the video carefully and then do the hands-on while watching the video for the second time. Don't leave the video until you understand the topic. This developer certification exam tests your AWS knowledge specifically from a developer perspective. To pass in this exam, you have to score 720 marks out of 1000. In this exam, two types of questions will come. First, multiple choices in which one correct option and three incorrect options are available. Second is multiple responses, in which two or more correct options are available out of five or more options. Don't forget to answer all the questions as no negative marking is there. Here is domain-wise distribution of the exam, in which deployment consists of 22%, security 26%, and the most important part is development with AWS services, which consists 30% of the exam. Refactoring consists 10% and monitoring and troubleshooting consists 12%. Also, read full exam guide on AWS website. A link is given in the description. If you have any questions on any topic, then you can tell me in the comment section. I personally answer each and every question asked in the comment section. That's all for now. See you in the next lecture.